here, we will surely get some of the videos. Should we perform an audit of those? Show my hands, those who have those videos. You are busy to show your hands. I'm sure if you do, we should do an audit of phones here, you will have some of those videos. And those videos can stay with you for life. The choice you make to film your love making or sex will have a consequential effect on you. And they can live with you for the rest of your life. For a consequential effect, seek for the alternatives before you make those decisions. And for alternatives, you need to talk to your counselor. I'm sure you have a lot of counseling units on campus. You know, we are also there, others are there. Go to them, approach them, and then they will take you through the right thing, the right procedure to help you, you know, with this one. I'm going to give you five things that you should know, then I will just open the floor for questions. Now, you have to ask yourself, what is important and valuable to you? Before you make those, what is so important and valuable to you? I've already stated some of the, you know, questions that you ask yourself before you make the decisions. Number two is that you shouldn't lose focus on your future. Remember, ladies, your future includes children, isn't it?
Yes.
Your future includes children. So you are not just making those decisions now. You have to think about your future. So when ladies come to me, the first question I ask myself, I mean, sometimes parents come, even pastors come to my office with their daughters pregnant. And at a point you want to abort it. There are some reasons they give all the time. Oh, my future, my education, my this. You have forgotten that your future includes children. What if you have all the wealth in this world and you do not have a child? What if you have all the qualification in this world and you do not have a child? Your future includes children. So yes, the best is to abstain from sex. But we know that it is not an easy choice. It's a choice for you to abstain, but sometimes it can be difficult. Another choice to make is to use a condom. But you see, the irony of this is that in all of this, women are at a disadvantageous position. It is the men who do the thrusting. You know what is thrusting? Up and down, up and down. Hey, I said, I'm making just a move to for 1 year. Ladies, are you here?
Yes.
Most of the time, it's the men who do the thrusting. The thrusting. So, if you have made a choice to use a condom and you are just lying down, missionary position. Do you know what has happened to the condom? Do you know what has happened to it? And from experience, a lot of men tear the condom without your knowledge. You don't know what has happened to the condom when he is doing it. And he is holding his manhood and doing everything without your knowledge. When you are lying down, Kolem. So the choice to use a condom has a consequential effect
on your life and on others around you. So you have to think about your future, my ladies. Have you looked at all the alternatives I have spoken about? How important is this decision, and how are you willing to work on it? Lastly, don't forget to use intuition in your decision making on campus. Intuition means you sit down critically, assess the situation, analyze the impacts, with having all the other sides before you take the decision. Use your intuition. And don't just look at what is happening around you immediately, and it will help you. Regarding having expectations, all of us have expectations, but as I gave my example, we want to become lawyers, we want to become doctors, we want to become this, we want to become that. They are all very good. Sometimes when you are given a course on campus, you don't like it, but I can tell you that no course is a bad course. There is no course on campus that is a bad course. In fact, university education prepares you to enable you to face all challenges when you are confronted with one. And I'm glad Dr. mentioned, even if you are a doctor, you are aspiring to be a doctor, you can decide that this is what, I have 1 year free, let me go and learn the accountancy profession. That's not what I want to do, but I want to get those certificates, or at least a course in accountancy in case. So university education just prepares you to be able to face all the challenges. So sometimes your expectations don't come the way you want it. And what you have thought about does not always happen the way you want it. And it's important that you have an open mind to enable you to look at other things that come. Somebody can do psychology, somebody can do physiology, and that person may even get a job faster than someone who did accountancy or, you know, something of the sort on campus, because of what you might have done with your life. And of course, as I stated in my example earlier, sometimes God can also give you a different direction and you need to go those times. May the Almighty God be with you.
Amen.
To make choices that are informed.
Amen.
To make choices that have less impacts on your life in the future. Maybe. Any questions?
I'd like to appreciate you, and may God richly bless you and increase you in knowledge. Amen.
Amen.
My question goes this way: where, when, and how can I get you? Thank you.
Okay, I'll give you my number in the air. Next question. So you make your pens and papers ready.
Please, your question. Sometimes we have our choices to make, but I use myself as an example. I know I'm very good in dancing.
Yeah.
I can dance. I can
dance.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm also good in fashion, but I'm going to talk about clothing.
Okay.
Yes. But I have this talent, and something I do tell my mom, "Mom, I'm persevering a day." Then I was like, asking when the
person
said
Pedeye.
Then I do go to my...
Pedeye, then what do you want to dance,
okay,
or what?
Today.
Pedeye, sir.
What kind of dance are that?
Choreography. Okay.
To make up, organize and stuff. And I'm over the fashion now. Like, set up economic business, 20. I have eyes in Kakade, the Because I can't make cash on them, I'm going to pay them a day. I say, ah, mommy, what is it? In English, can you not be grateful? But I know that, meaning there, me a year or that one, I can go to a counselor and look at, oh, mommy, what choice is here? Hey, I have a thing, or a fool. But me, I'm winning, not you.
Okay, all right.
Thank you very much. My name is Andrews. Please, I want to ask a very simple question. You talk about sex inter and ster. Most of the time, it's not the wish of the ladies to have sex. Someone is automatic. It's not the wish of them to have sex. It's with the boys who force them to come to us. See, for a lady asking of sex, it's very difficult for her. It's very difficult. It's only one who will ask that one. I want them to have sex.
Yeah, please keep quiet and listen to him. Let's give him the
question I want to ask is,
yes,
is that we shouldn't have sex, we should use condom when we use
I haven't said anything like that. Did I say something like that? No!
He said when
you
use condom, at least the condom can tear. The voice can tear. So I want to ask, what can you tell me the voice over here to do? So that's not that we can even limit those kind of pregnant, so that we can even...
There is only one word, what is pure and simple.
Thank you.
Yes, next question. So I didn't even write that. It has been answered.
Please, let's take for example, I've enjoyed unprotected sex. Now, and I know that's consequential, right? Is it consequential?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because you can have HIV. I didn't want to go into that. I'll give you one example. There is a church in Ghana. One assembly. Only one assembly. A young man died, and everybody suspected the young man of having HIV. The young man died. In fact, the young man was a choir master. He died, and everybody suspected the young man of having died of AIDS. No, it had grown, so having died of AIDS. It is just one assembly out of the lot. So one Sunday morning, inspired by the Holy Spirit or something, I mean, in church, you see the Holy Spirit inspired the presiding elder. So he stood on the platform and said, we have heard that our member who has just died of HIV or died of AIDS, and we have heard that he has slept with some of the ladies here. If you are here and he slept with you and you don't come forward to be prayed for, you will also die like he did. That Sunday morning alone, Monkai Mame, why? Eight ladies came in front of the congregation to be prayed for. One Sunday morning. How about those who didn't come to church that Sunday? So it has a consequential effect and a very serious one if you have unprotected sex. Go ahead.
Yeah. Let's take for example there. Consequences begin to follow. Okay?
Yeah.
Now, does it mean the persona's life is doom and gloom yet?
No, your life is not doom. There is a way out. As I said, you need to talk to us. Your life is not doom. In fact, I won't even say, because otherwise you will go and practice it. Go. Your life is not doom, so you talk to us. Okay? That is why we are there.
Two more questions.
Yeah.
Please, my name is Nana
Ajua. Nana Ajua. Nana Yao.
from Nansuma. I wanted to advise my colleague that we are here that sex before marriage is not good. Sometimes, if you advise your friend that sex before marriage is not good, you'll tell you that, oh, you're Kolo, don't know what's happening. Sex, yeah. Sometimes, I listen to Mama Zini, we always advise the young girls who are coming on that sex before marriage is not good. Sometimes, if you are working, we have three male friends and two male friends, if you are working and talking about sex, sometimes I don't want to hear what they are saying, but what my brother said is true. Sometimes the guy who asks for sex is not asking the ladies who ask for sex. So if you are a lady and
ask, you have a choice to make when the gentleman asks. And what is that choice?
No, sorry.
You have a choice to make. We are talking about choices here.
Yes.
When a gentleman asks for sex, so long as he hasn't put anything in your drink or food, and you have your physical eyes,